Let me go into staff. Do you want me to start right now?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Is it ready?
So, hello guys. My name is Raichu. I'm from Bulgaria. I suffered to ISU for quite a bit. I did the SSP program and then the master program. Afterwards, my career turned in different paths and quite interesting, I'll say. I returned to Bulgaria actually and created a very modern educational program for students in Sofia University about science and technology, basically something like SSP, but it's completely free of charge for the students, and we invite a lot of experts every year to educate our students. This photo actually was done by my students for only 2.5 months after the program started. It's a photo around 33 kilometers altitude that they, my students, constructed by themselves apparatuses and sent them to the stratosphere, performed about 12 different experiments for science and technology. Basically, this gave us a little bit of self-esteem to try to also create a very modern center. The center that we are currently right now in Stuttgart is amazing. Here in Stuttgart we have this amazing center that it was just created a year and a half ago. I've been here to the inauguration ceremony. It was amazing because it's a center that gives a lot of different students opportunities to build with their friends actual space-related stuff. So what we started in Bulgaria is creating actually educational centers for technology, science and entrepreneurship. I'll show you a little bit the mission, the vision. We want to create high-tech entrepreneurs. And by entrepreneurs, what we understand, the team that I'm working with and I have the pleasure to work with, is practically to create the next breed of scientists and technologists and to give them the opportunity, the microfinancing, so that they can actually create by themselves companies based on their own solutions, visions, etc. The goal is to disseminate and store scientific and technological knowledge, to organize new educational models. I'll speak very briefly about that. And of course, to foster entrepreneurial skills, because it's very important in Eastern Europe. We're just starting now to realize that it's important and it's not bad to fail. When you try to make a company, maybe it's not successful the first time, but this is actually good. You can learn from it and continue doing something else. So as an example of really good online education, because the educational systems in the world are changing dramatically the past few years, is the Udacity. It's made by Google. It's a school where you have online courses in different technical issues. You can even build a robot car by yourself and a bunch of a team of students around you. You can be in Bulgaria, you can be anywhere in the world. You can just take the course even from your smartphone, and it's really amazing. The other type of course is Coursera, where leading universities of the world have opened a lot of modules for education in engineering, different technologies, etc., mathematics, edX, MIT and Harvard and Berkeley just created recently. From those different experiments, there were quite a few young people's companies made. This was in NASA 2010. I had the pleasure to be in the same program like those guys. They created by themselves seemingly crazy idea to create a 3D printer for the ISS, for the space station, but actually continued forward with the project, got financed, and they stayed in NASA Center to continue developing further the project. This year, I think, or next year, they're even planning to launch a small 3D printer on board the ISS. So basically, in Moscow, in Eastern Europe, there are also a lot of things happening. Skolkovo Institute is very modern facility. Skolkovo Foundation is a few hundred millions of euros that they are investing in creating a worldwide state-of-the-art center for technologies and sciences. So for us, we started to think how to make it into our local environment. Obviously, we don't have 100 million euros to spend on a high-tech center, although we would like to. But we have a lot of good people, we have a team, we have even already potential investors that are really certain that are going to invest into the project. And we have obviously hunger for the young people to develop those photos again done by the students in Space Challenge program. I encourage you to see it. So the concept is basically to create a co-working lab, educational center, co-working space and a business incubator inside it. Basically the idea when you come to the courses that we organized and I created as a program is 80% of the time you are working with your hands and on actual hardware and software you are developing it. Only 20% of the time you are lectured. So this would go on inside the center as well. The center will be around 1,000 square meters first, and it will have a lot of laboratories will be in an open space environment where the young people taking different modules in nanotechnologies, biotechnologies, engineering, they will have the synergies and they will find their own synergies to create companies inside the center itself. So the co-working lab has a lot of potential. We are working already, we have courses for 3D printing technologies with the latest technology to have inside the center. We are using the model of Tech Shop in San Francisco. You can see a lot of people coming, gathering, and performing with their hands different types of materials. And of course, the biotechnological sciences. And we are trying to cooperate right now with the leading experts from leading institutes around the world. They are actually supporting us. We're just starting to develop also a board of trustees also in the project. The co-working space, I suppose all of you know what co-working space is. Basically, are desks and chairs put together, but no boundaries, no walls, and a young person can come, rent his small office, and then can start meeting people, they create their own synergies, and from that you derive even a business solution. This is our main goal. Our main goal is in the first 3 years to have created at least 5 growing, developing companies by young people who have come to the center. Now, this is how serious we are about the center. This is actually the building that we are going to use. We already created a SWOT analysis of this building. We have 4 buildings actually. This is the primary task for now. You can see inside the building we have only one auditorium that will serve, that will also serve as a planetarium probably. We want to have engineering bay, biotech lab as I mentioned, nanotech lab, an architectural corner, and engineering bay and architectural corner will be actually really close to one another. So that, for example, you are working on an AI and robotic system and you can come to some architect and perform together some kind of project and you can just find amazing synergies between the students of the program. So practically in this project I'm really hopeful that it will be ready in less than 1 year. We started from nothing, from zero. No one knew anything about those technologies at the level that we want to have it in Bulgaria. 3 years in investing my own money and efforts into the space challenges program and meeting the right people, we started to develop the concept of actually starting and building a center. Now we are up to the point that we have even the design of the center inside and the building. And this is like a photo of the building just to appreciate one of the potential buildings. It's a really old building from the Soviet era. You can imagine the contrast inside. You have this tremendous amount of young spirits and efforts done by young people. At the same time, you have it inside this huge monolithic building constructed by in the times of the Soviet era. So practically that's it, and I just wanted to mention that don't give up on your crazy ideas, because this is the most important part of your life, is the chance to prove the others that they're wrong, or to prove that your concept might be working. So thank you and good luck.
You said you spoke to the right people to like have the first design of the institute. But I mean, if you want to create big laboratories and so on, you need funding for that.
Definitely need funding. Your question is where the funding will come from?
Exactly. Yeah.
No, first let me explain something. Meeting the right people means that in your life, and especially what ISU is really strong in, is the networking. So we start meeting people seriously. When I came here, I came to my program in Bulgaria, used partially the connections that I had when I was studying in ISU, partially my own connections. When we started developing and financing our own program for space education in Sofia University, we got to meet a lot of other people, because people who came to teach our students, they actually believe in the concept and they say, oh, you know that guy that is somewhere around in another country, why don't you call him? They are just trying to invest, for example, into a program that is similar to what you are doing here in Bulgaria. You can find synergies. So you try to find synergies. Secondly, the uniqueness presented will be that it will be self-sustainable. This means you have a co-working space where a young person, if he or she wants to develop a company, she will pay a small amount of money. Absolutely affordable, but she will pay, or he will pay this amount of money. This makes the center self-affordable. From there, when you make a real business case, we got to the point that I made a business plan with the motivation of the equipment deal. So we are accounting how much money we need as a real business case, not as a donation, not as a dotation of some investor that will never return the money, totally the opposite. The idea is for the center to be self-sustainable from day one and to continue to grow and to develop. It's like a living creature. The center will be like a living body cells. That you, when someone exponent, because the exponential growth of the technologies such as biotech, nanotech and other types of AI and robotics, those technologies are developing so fast that you need to, in order to stay on top or at the state of the art at this current moment, you need to change equipment constantly, you need to modify your modules, create new modules. So we want that into the center. The only way that we can do that is to have it self-sustainable. Therefore, any investor that comes on board, he will be happy because he will not just lose any some money on non-profit idea. He will actually invest into the creation of other entrepreneurial efforts of young people with the main goal of creating their own companies, helping them having a small percentage participation in those companies. Imagine why not create the next Google, for example, in Bulgaria, 2D center, but based on technology, yeah, because Google was actually created into a garage. It started like that. Obviously, afterwards there was significant investment, etc. But any idea starts from a small step. So we want to keep those small steps and to see how the ideas develop. So from this point, we're not. Also, we have a lot of different programs we can use for financing. We're actually already developing courses for two real programs. So we have quite a good chances to get partial funding for the first part of the equipment. So we are absolutely looking at that from a business perspective. This means created as a, in order to, so something to be alive, this is the main problem in the space sector from my point of view. Is all the companies are dependent on some donation, national governmental funding. They're not functioning in a normal business case. You need your organization to function in a normal business case. You need to have a little bit of profit or a lot of profit. To have profit is a good thing because you can develop, you can experiment, you can give boost to many young people. The idea is to have a small fund, all the profit at the center, almost all of the profit at the center, we go outside of financing the modules, we go to microfinance companies, we go to give scholarships to the best students that we can find in the country. We don't have age requirements, this means you can be 15 years old, come take the nanotechnology courses, modules by leading experts, prove that you are good and valuable, and you can, on 18 years old, you can be even a guru in this technology. And it's better that way. We're not putting any artificial boundaries. 80% of the time you're working with your hands inside of the laboratories, you are not bullshitting or telling blah blah. You're just actually working and trying to create your vision. And this is what I believe will make the center really strong in this case. Anybody more questions?
Yeah, can I just ask what sort of initial investment you'd be looking at to assess something?
It's really, at this point, I can tell you the whole figures, but I prefer to, it's realistic. It's in the sphere of a few hundred thousand euro initial investment, but it really depends if we are going to choose this building, because I made with the architects SWOT analysis of four different buildings. There is a sensitivity because there are buildings that are privately funded, that for me is the better way, and we have to pay a rent to be there. There are buildings that are administered by the local government, so this means we may be able to make a contract that we are developing local region, and they give us for free some time to develop the concept and to prove the concept we're working. But based on that, it's pure, super realistic. It's not like hundreds of millions of euros to be spent. Totally opposite. The idea is to start. We first define what we want to have as an output of the courses. Then we develop the courses. We are currently developing the courses, and based on that, we're developing the equipment that we need to foster those entrepreneurial efforts in science and technology that we want to see.
Right. So at the preliminary stage, how many people can you accommodate?
I can show you the slide with the building, but practically in the planetarium auditorium to want to create, for example, there will be a place for 120 people. Overall, it will not be a huge center, totally different. I believe that the most efficient way for having a practical education is through having teams of less than 20 people. So this means in every moment in the laboratories you have no more than 20 people taking this particular course. If there is a huge interest in the course, obviously you can organize a few sessions of the same course during the period of time. But normally it's the way the effectiveness would work. You need them. For us, the people who we are assembling right now, a team, most of them are really renowned experts in the fields that they are tutoring or mentoring. And those people will be your mentors. You come, you learn by yourself, you break your hands, your head to the wall by trying your efforts and realizing this is very difficult or this is quite easy, I didn't expect to be so easy. And the teachers will be actually mentors, they will just guide you through the process of you becoming a better professional. And that's the idea of the center. But this kind of center is proven, if the concept is proven with a co-working lab, which is purely our concept, I haven't seen it at least realized in practice the way that we envision it. I think it will be an amazing model to be followed by different countries, regions, and to create synergies. We are so super open, we don't have any secretive stuff, or the idea is to have complete openness even when we're developing online content that will be available in English, it will be available for the whole world, because we want to organize conferences in Bulgaria. We have already conferences like TED and other conferences. We have the idea of having those kind of things happen into the center when it's ready in about 12 months. So I'm going to go with that. Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
This could be, okay, so who here isn't ISU already? Toby.